Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install latest version of MongoDB, that is MongoDB version 8.2.0
in
Windows operating system.
After that, I am also going to
show you how to use
data,
this latest MongoDB for creating database, creating collection, inserting data and all of that. So this video will be a bit long, but guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you will be learning a lot of new things. So now to install MongoDB, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and you type over here MongoDB download, hit enter. So that will show you this mongodb.com as a first source result. So you have to go to this MongoDB community server download. So that's going to redirect to this page. So remember, you need to download MongoDB community edition. So scroll down and you'll be able to see this 8.2.2 current version. So this link, by the way, I'm going to provide right in our channel description, so you can use that link to land over here. Once when you're here, depending upon what operating system you're using, Windows or Linux or macOS, you know, you can switch to all these different operating systems. You can clearly see Ubuntu is also there. So you need to select that and you need to download the respective package. We are going to download it for Windows, so that's why I'm going to keep it default and I'm going to click on this download button. So immediately it's going to start downloading our latest version of MongoDB. You can see it is clearly started downloading. Since I have already downloaded it, so that's why I'm going to cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory and here you can see that exact same version of MongoDB is already been downloaded over here. The file size is 755 MB. So to install, just simply double click on that installer. So welcome to MongoDB 8.2.2 setup. So let's minimize our download directory and click on next over here. So this is our license agreement. You must read this, accept it and click on next. So here it is telling what type of installation that you'd like to do. So I always recommend to proceed with complete installation. So select that. So that's going to show you the service configuration page. Here, this is going to be our service name, which is MongoDB. All other things you need to keep it default and click on next. So it is telling whether you'd like to also install MongoDB Compass. You want, because I'm going to show you how to create collection, database, then insert data and everything. So for that, we are going to use a GUI or graphic user interface. So that is what MongoDB Compass will give us. So keep it default selected and click on next. So it's ready to be installed. Click on install. Going to ask you for administrative privileges, click on yes and our installation for MongoDB is rightly began. So let's wait for a couple of minutes to get it finished installing our MongoDB. So by the time our MongoDB get installed, you can also check out our cool Python project playlist. So all these videos you can see, so some of the project goes by this building a rock paper scissor game using Pygame Tinter, or how to deploy a Python Flask app on some server, and that too for completely free. Alright, so everything that I've showed you are all free and very good projects. You should be, you know, learning a lot of new things once you start watching this playlist. So how to build a resume builder Python app. So that's going to have some forms. So you just fill all these forms and click on generate the PDF, and that's going to generate a resume for you. So you can watch all these videos, and the best part is detailed source code for all these videos are also available on our official geekyscript.com website. So you can see it has detailed explanation of what we are actually doing, along with the detailed source code also I have mentioned. So you can check all this out. I'm sure you are going to love them and you are going to learn a lot of new things as well. So to check out all these things and our other videos that are there on our channel, I'm sure you are going to love all of them. Here, let's wait for a few more minutes. So welcome back. So now you can clearly see that our MongoDB Compass and MongoDB all are rightly installed. So now it is showing welcome to Compass. So you can just simply click on start over here. So this is the interface of our MongoDB Compass when you install it for the very first time. So let's maximize it and click on this add new collection over here. So that's going to open this new connection window. I have to provide name and color. So let's give some name. So let's give something like my demo connection, like con. All right. And give some color. This is totally your wish. I'm giving something, something like blue, because that's one of my favorite colors. And so just give something like that. You can also make it favorite this connection so that it will get pinned on the top, and click on save and connect. So that's going to establish that connection. So you are connected to my demo con. Welcome to MongoDB Compass. You are connected to your my demo connection. If you want to create one more connection, so that also you can do. You can just click on this plus icon, and you can again give your name, color, and you can, you know, put it over here. I'm going to cancel this. So this is my connection. Already you can see some of the databases that are already been created over here. So let's create a fresh database. So click on this, and then click on this plus icon. So that will show you this create database window. Here you need to provide your database name. So let's give the database name as demo chess players, and you need to provide a collection name as well. So let's give the collection name as players, and click on create database. So that's going to create a brand new database called demo chess players and a players connection as well. Here, if you already having data available, so you can just import it from this button, import JSON or CSV file. So you need to just click on that, and it browse that file, and yeah, your data going to show up over here. Or else you can also insert this document to create your very own data. So that's going to open this insert document window. Here you need to switch to this hamburger icon, and you can see one object ID available already here. Just click on this plus icon and add a field after ID. So here just provide a fresh field name called name, and just give something over here. So let's give a name called Anand. So click on insert, and you can see that data is properly inserted over here, right? If you want to insert one more data, just proceed with the same operation. Click on add data, insert document, go to this hamburger icon, click on plus, add a field after ID, give name, and give another name. Let's give our current world chess champion, which is Gukesh, and click on insert, and you can see it is inserted. Let's say you want to edit it. How you do that? So click on this pencil icon, and you can see now you can edit over here. So you can put any name. So let's say Pragu gonna be our next year's world chess champion. So Pragu, click on update, and you can see it is done now. And to modify it to Arjun. So how easy it is. You want to clone it. So click on this clone icon and go to your hamburger icon, and you modify this. You make it Nihal. So click on insert, and you can see it is inserted now. Alright. So that's how you do. Let's say you want to delete it as well. So just there is a delete button. So click on delete, and it is gone. So no offense to Nihal, I'm showing how to delete it. Alright. So I have clearly showed you how to install MongoDB and MongoDB Compass, and how you can start working on MongoDB Compass. If you're liking this video, please give it a like, share, and subscribe. That would really motivate me to make more the similar kind of videos. And so don't forget to watch all these different videos that are there on our channel. I'm sure you are going to love them. So that is basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.